What's up, y'all? So I got my expander on around like 1 o'clock. It's now like almost 8 o'clock at night. This is challenging. I can't even talk with my son back there. It's really challenging to talk with my tongue behind this. I've been trying. Eating is no fun. I couldn't even finish my food. I made some veggie tacos with like quinoa, and I mean, it was all everywhere. Like tacos, I will not be eating tacos no more. Honestly, I think I'm gonna stick to like some soup or like a protein shake or something. Maybe a smoothie. I'm really discouraged right now. That was no fun eating. And eating is like my favorite thing to do in life. Like, I look forward to eating. That sounds so bad, but it's true. So that just kind of pissed me off. Because when I ate, it was just everywhere. And then, you know, you got to use the top of your mouth to bite into the taco. I mean, it was stuck all in there. So I started trying to bite from the side. Still was a hot mess. So, yeah, I hope I only have to keep this in for 2 months and we can take this out. Hopefully, I see a lot of progress in 2 months like I did with, like I did with my open bite closing in 5 weeks with just my brace. So, I'm going to talk to my or so. Hopefully, you know, it's the first day. I'll probably get used to it. I'm already like, get this out of my mouth. But I know I need to learn to talk without my tongue. That's my big issue. And I don't like talking with my tongue. But this is horrible. Listen to me. I don't want to talk like this. Nobody can understand me. And I look stupid. And I can barely swallow. I ain't gagged so many times. Especially after I'm eating and I was trying to rinse my mouth out. Spitting. It's just a horrible mess here. I'm wrecked. So, I was trying to swallow. That's what that was. But I thought I would turn the camera and let you guys know my raw emotions and how I'm feeling right now. Because I feel defeated by this appliance. It's messing with me. It's no fair. I just want my teeth to be straight and I just want this to be over with. But this is a part of the journey. It's part of the process. And I'm trying to train myself to talk without my tongue. And this is just what I'm going to have to go through. So, the hardest thing is swallowing. I feel like I'm going to swallow my freaking tongue. And, yeah, y'all. So, whatever. I'm just venting and complaining. And I need to stop. But really, it just pissed me off because I tried to eat and I couldn't. And I'm still fucking hungry. So, I'm going to have to figure out if I can drink me a protein shake or something. I don't want to lose no more weight. I'm already skinny as hell. I've been eating good, trying to gain a little weight because I'm 139 and I want to be 150. So, I've been trying to eat good so I can gain weight. So, I'm a little afraid I might lose weight. I don't want to be no smaller than 139. It's already small. I'm 5'6". That's too damn small. So, whatever. Bye, guys.
I'm laying here in the bed. It's really late night, but I'm watching a lot of YouTube videos of people turning their expander like twice a day. So I come to the decision tomorrow. I'm going to go get my key and I'm going to try to turn my expander myself so that it'll work faster. Because I feel like I can do it. I can pretty much see back there and put the key, and I think I'll be able to turn it. I think I can do it. I don't know why I doubted myself. I know I can do it. But two, I'm also just sitting here talking to my 2-year-old, and I have been keeping my tongue back, and I feel like I'm talking better. I don't feel like I sound as bad. I feel like I can understand myself. I don't know if you guys can understand me. But two, I want my kids to get used to hearing me talk like this, because this is the way I have to talk, so I've just been trying to say a lot of S words. But yeah, like I was saying, I've been trying to say a lot of S words because S words are the biggest struggle for me. So I'm working on that. I feel like I'm getting better. I think I just got discouraged earlier because I couldn't eat and I was really hungry. I'm going to try to eat some cereal here in a little bit because I'm getting hungry. My daughter talking about some, hey Siri, call Daddy. She's funny. Not hey Siri, call Daddy. Well, she wants to call Daddy. So, but yeah, let's give you guys an update. Tomorrow I'm going to go get my key and we're going to start turning this thing by myself.
It's 12:20 at night. And earlier was a fail with tacos. So, I was going to have a late night snack, try to eat some cereal. That was a fail. I had a headache really bad earlier. I don't know if it's because I'm tired or if it's from the expander. But the only thing that hurts is this expander, like in between my teeth when I chew. That did not feel good. When I chew, that is messing with my teeth. It hurts. So, but other than that, I'm just disappointed. I gotta find some food that I can eat to make me happy.
So it's the next morning. I still have not got used to talking like this. I'm trying though. It's really hard. I'm spitting everywhere because I can barely swallow. This morning, this is what I'm drinking for breakfast because I tried to eat some cereal last night and it was a fail. My teeth hurt where this appliance is in between my teeth and back. Excuse me. Up in the thing here is where the appliance is at and it hurts. So she has shoved it up in between my teeth. I'm so sorry. I've seen some people get spacers before they get in. She didn't do that. She just shoved it up there. And it didn't feel good when she did it. And now it really does not feel good at all. So I hope that goes away soon. I am practicing talking like this. But I am going to go get my key to my expander. I left it there because we did agree that she would turn it for me. But I don't know why I doubted myself. I feel like I can turn it myself. So, I am going to go get my key. They're not back at the Fisher's location until Wednesday. Next Wednesday. So, I'm going to miss some turns. But I'm going to also talk with her and ask her how many times will I need to turn it myself. But yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know that it's no fun. Nothing about this is fun. It's pretty horrible. But this is day two of having it. I heard about the third day is better, so I hope so. And I know eventually my talking will get better as long as I keep practicing and talking with my tongue behind this thing. So that's what I'm going to do, but yeah, I think the worst thing is just not being able to eat what I want to and the pain I'm going through right now because it's, like I said, hurting my teeth. My jaw, I think, is really sore. For some odd reason, my jaw was sore down here. I felt like I was having pain down here. I don't know why. I thought the pain was, I don't know. And I had a bad headache yesterday, but I don't know if that was from the expander or because I was sleeping. But yeah, I'm going to get used to it. It'll get better. I know it will. I'll have more positive updates for y'all soon. Trying to have a late night snack. I made some chicken noodles. And at this point, eating is just horrible. I mean, I'm hungry. Like, I love having a late night snack. I'm trying to eat a chip. Mm. It hurt my teeth. This is depressing. I'll say the most annoying thing is trying to eat. Definitely talking is still an issue and swallowing. But that doesn't make me as sad as trying to eat. I don't even care to talk. I just want to eat. Can I eat these noodles? So this is the deal. Excuse me. I thought I heard my baby crying, but it's sirens outside. What's going on? We're from a... Sorry, y'all, I'm trying to eat, but there's so much stuff stuck at the top of this thing, it's impossible. I'm just over it. Tomorrow I'm gonna go to the store and get me a bunch of protein shakes because it looks like that's all I'm gonna be able to have. And mashed potatoes. But I already have a lot of mashed potatoes. Probably give me some sushi. So that's soft. This really sucks. Like, this really sucks really badly. But I just keep telling myself it's only temporarily. Right now, I'm not talking with my tongue behind this thing. I just want to eat in peace. That's all. I don't know it's not gonna be forever, but this is really fucking depressing. I'm really mad at myself for doing all this damage to my teeth and sucking my thumb for so long. And it's like, I be trying to eat on this side, but you can't, like, how you enjoy your food is having that, you know, tasting it, putting it on your tongue. But I can't use the top of my mouth. This is horrible. Like, for dinner, I ate some mashed potatoes, green beans, and I fried some catfish. That was a perfect meal to eat. I'm gonna be wearing that out because it wasn't too bad. This shit, no. Chips, no. And I knew that when I was pouring the shit. And I was thinking in my head, what am I thinking but pouring all these chips? I ain't about to be able to eat this. I'm sorry, that's what I'm asking. Y'all, eating is horrible. I'm just complaining. I'm just venting to you guys. Talking could have been not that awesome either. Talking is horrible. But I've been trying to talk like this so my kids will start to understand me. And I'll be spitting everywhere. I'm definitely going to try to finish these noodles. Probably not too much of it. I ain't going to eat the whole thing, but some of it, because the whole point of me eating because I'm hungry. Even though I ate dinner around probably like 5:30. It's almost 11 o'clock at night. I'm feeling hungry. I should have just warmed up the mashed potatoes I cooked. But yeah. Just want to upgrade you guys. I have not been the most positive. I've been having an attitude out of work. I'm moody. This just sucks. It really does, to be honest. I am not happy about it. I'm not a happy camper. I was ready for it to be over, honestly. And I know it's not going to be over soon. So, I'm just ready to get used to it, actually, you know, because I know it's not going to be out of my mouth soon. I'm pretty sure she didn't really talk to me about how long I'm going to have it, because she knows I'm going to have it for a while. And, I watched a video, and a girl said that her dentist didn't tell her how long either, or she lied to her and told her, but she ended up having it in for like 5-6 months or even longer. Because once you have it in, even if you see change, if you take it right out, it'll go back. So they have to keep it in, so your jaw will like adjust to, you know, the new size that it is. So it's gonna have to be in there for a while. So I'm just mentally preparing myself for that, and I'm just trying to be positive and know that it'll be over soon. And you know, I just don't want to be real negative. It's already a lot of negative stuff going on in the world, so I'm just trying to be positive and be thankful for what I have, and that I'm able to experience this and go through this to better my teeth and better myself and my self-esteem. It's something that I just didn't like about myself, and I was tired of looking at, and it happened so fast. Like my top teeth, I've always had an open bite, but my bottom teeth begin to come out too and be, you know, make that open bite even worse. Because my bottom teeth for a while were really straight and pretty. It was just my top teeth stuck out. But, you know, as I got older and it shifted, I just started to be really unhappy with my teeth, the way that I talked. People couldn't even understand me with my open bite then. So, you know, my list was really bad. So now I'm just thankful I don't have to go clock in at a job every day and have this in my mouth and be talking to people, because that was my job that I had. I was a front desk receptionist for an eye doctor. So I was constantly answering the phone, people walking up, talking to people, checking in people for their appointments, checking out people sometimes. So I'm just thankful I don't have to do that with this in my mouth. So I'm just trying to look, you know, at all the positive things, even though there is some stuff I'm going through that's making me irritated. Really, it's just not being able to eat. I can handle the not being able to, you know, chalk properly. And I feel like my swallowing has gotten better. It's not as bad as it was the first day. But, you know, I'm just going to go to the store tomorrow and get me some foods that I can eat that are not going to really bother me. And I think that'll make me more positive. So I'll come back tomorrow and let you guys know what foods I got at the store and what I'm going to be eating.
Hey, y'all. I always come on here looking a hot mess, but I don't care. I'm in the house chilling, and I just wanted to give y'all an update. I feel like I'm getting better with talking. It's not perfect, but today is day 3, and I've been talking like this all day. I'll keep my tongue behind it so that I can get used to talking. And I'm trying to use the swallowing, but it hasn't been too bad today. I did go to the store and I got like some sushi, and I forgot to give me some protein shakes. Luckily, I already have some, but I do gotta go back and get that. And just like soft foods to eat, bite some pizza. It wasn't too bad, but yeah, just wanted to give a little short update. Not too much going on. Just still working on swallowing and talking. So me and my baby just sitting here chilling. Friday night. Today feels day 3. But I know earlier I mentioned that I got sushi when I was at the store. And sushi did me good. Like,
I could eat it. So that's my new fave. I mean, I love sushi anyway, but now that I know I can eat it no problem, I'm about to be wearing some sushi out. So I'm happy about that. I'm feeling much better today. I'm in better spirits. And I had planned to have a birthday dinner at hibachi place, so I was getting a little discouraged, like, can I still go eat? Yes, I'm gonna get me some sushi. And I feel like I'm talking a little better. I hope you guys can understand me. It's still hard to talk, it's still hard to swallow, but I think I got this, you know. Soon it's gonna be no problem. I'm gonna be talk without my tongue, so I'm trying my best. I do not talk without putting my tongue behind this tongue cage, and I feel like it's getting better. I'm learning and I'm practicing. Hey, nigga, we so H-O-O-B, then we dwell in the South, S-I-D-E. S-O-U-T-H-S-I-D-E, where them dub niggas strive for me. Hey, I'm from that S-O-U-T-H-S-I-D-E, where them dub niggas strive for me. Hey, I'm from that S-O-U-T-H-S-I-D-E, where them dub niggas strive for me. Hey, I'm from that S-O-U-T-H-S-I-D-E, where them dub niggas strive for me.